Hi everyone, let's discuss about the B-Weekly Contest 7 second question, design file system. So you are being asked to design a file system which provide two function, a create a path with a given value and then get the value from a path. So the condition is we can only create a path. So the structure of the path is something like slash lead slash code. So if you want to create the slash code, you need the slash lead axis first. So yeah, if you're able to create the path and give it a value, you return a true. But if a path is already exists with a value, then you return a false. Or if the parent path doesn't exist, you also return a false. Like let's say slash lead slash code, we never create the slash lead, then we should return a false in that case. And when we want to get it, if the path is not valid, means the path is not valid, we return a minus one. Or yeah, of course that means that part never created, like whether it's the parent or the child, right? So after that, let's see the example. First example is very simple. We create a part slash a with value one, and then we get the value of slash a, which return one. On second example, we can see like we create a slash lead with value of one, and then after that we create slash lead slash code with value of two. So this should return true because slash lead is already created, so we can create the slash code with value of two. And when we try to get the slash lead slash code, it should return true. But on the second sample, slash c slash d, we input one. This will return a false because slash c doesn't exist. So yeah, the one is never stored. And then when we try to access file system get slash c, it should return minus one because that path is not exist. Even though we say slash c slash d, it should also return minus one because this creation is a failure. Right. Yeah, so how we gonna do that? We do a trees. So the trees data structure have a value inside of each path. And it also have a nested trees with a string as the path. So for example, slash lead is one trees, and inside slash lead, we have slash code. So this will be, the key will be code, and it will have another trees with the value of two, right? So yeah, we initialize our constructor with root of an empty trees. And then when we try to create a path, we split our path by the slash, right? And if the path is less than one, we return a false, means the path is an empty path, right? So we should return a false. And the other reason is like after we split, let's say we do a slash path slash b, right? So in that case, slash path slash b, it will return an index of an empty string from the right part of the slash, and then a path, and then a b. So we don't want to process the first one. That's why we validate if it's less or equals to one. And when it's not, we start from the first index, which is the real path, the path itself, and the second path. So we start from index one until the end of the index minus one, because we don't want to navigate through the B. We don't want to go to inside the B, because when you want to create path, you actually want to create the path of B. So we only navigate until this one, right? So start from root, you loop through the path. So if the path doesn't exist, means this folder is not there. Let's name it A. If A doesn't exist, we return a false because it's not a valid parent folder. Otherwise, we keep digging in, right? And yeah, so on the last part, we didn't loop it because we already do minus one. Instead, we want to create that part. So we create a new trees with the value we are given. And then current position, which the current is here on A. So the trees of A on the map, we put our new path, the B, and the trees itself. and the value is already stored in the trees, and we return a true in that case. But when we want to get it, we can do it in a very similar way, which we split it by the slash. And if it's less or equals to 1, we return a minus 1, because there is no value axis, we should return minus 1. And when it's valid, we try to navigate it through the root. So when we navigate, we don't do the minus 1 here, different from the create, because we actually expect the path of B axis, and then we want to know what is the value inside. So that's why we also iterate the B together in the for loop. And every time if a path doesn't exist in the current trees, means the path is invalid, we return minus 1 directly. But otherwise, we keep going in until the very end. We will end up on the trees of B, and we return the value of the trees. So that's it for get. Yeah. And that's it for this question. Thank you for watching. See you on the next weekly contest.